A Chinese automaker has just revealed an electric car that they say can drive more than 1,000 kilometers on a single charge, and they've actually shown the battery technology that makes it possible. So is this the moment gasoline cars finally become obsolete? This isn't coming from Tesla, Toyota, or any of the names you might expect. It's coming from Dongfeng Motor, a state-owned Chinese automaker with a long history of building trucks, buses, and passenger cars. At their latest strategic planning and product launch event in Wuhan, they did something most automakers are afraid to do. They laid all their cards on the table. Not only did they claim to have a solid-state battery-powered EV ready for mass production, but they shared actual numbers that sound almost unbelievable. A real-world range of over 1,000 kilometers per charge. A charging speed so fast it could add 450 kilometers of range in just 5 minutes. An energy density of 400 watt-hours per kilogram, a jump that experts have been chasing for decades. And they didn't just tease concept cars. They talked about production timelines, partnerships with Huawei, and global expansion plans. This is significant because in the EV world, most breakthroughs live in the lab for years, or even decades, before reaching customers. By publicly announcing these specs and partnerships, Dongfeng is signaling they're close to making it happen at scale. Why current EV batteries hold us back? To understand why this is such a big deal, you first need to know why most EVs today can't match this range or speed of charging. Most electric cars use lithium-ion batteries with liquid electrolytes. Think of the electrolyte as the highway that allows lithium ions, tiny charged particles, to move back and forth inside the battery when charging and discharging. Liquid electrolytes work well, but they come with three big drawbacks. Energy density limits. Energy density is like how much water you can fit in a bottle. Today's top EV batteries manage about 250 to 300 watt hours per kilogram, which is why most EVs max out at 400 to 600 kilometers per charge. Push them harder, and the battery gets bigger, heavier, and more expensive. Charging speed restrictions. Imagine filling a water balloon too quickly, it bursts. With liquid electrolytes, charging too fast causes heat buildup, which can damage the battery or cause dangerous failures. That's why fast charging often slows down after the first few minutes. Safety concerns. The liquid electrolyte is flammable. If the battery is damaged or overheats, it can catch fire. The infamous EV battery fire videos you sometimes see. Solid-state batteries replace that liquid with a solid electrolyte, and this simple swap changes almost everything. Here's why. Higher energy density. A solid electrolyte allows for more compact packing of energy, meaning you can fit more range into the same space. Dongfeng's 400 watt-hours per kilogram claim would be a 33% to 60% jump over today's best. Much faster charging. Solid electrolytes can handle higher voltages without overheating, enabling ultra-fast charging without damaging the battery. Improved safety. Without flammable liquids, the risk of fire is dramatically reduced. Even if punctured, solid-state cells are far less likely to burn. Longer lifespan. Solid electrolytes are more stable over time, meaning less battery degradation. Your EV could keep most of its range after hundreds of thousands of kilometers. If you think of battery technology as the bottleneck holding back EV adoption, solid state is like removing that bottleneck entirely. Here's where it gets technical, but I'll break it down for the non-engineers. Dongfeng's design uses silicon carbon composite anodes. Silicon can hold 10 times more lithium than graphite, which is used in most EVs today. But silicon expands when charged, which can cause cracking. Mixing it with carbon stabilizes it, like adding rebar to concrete. High nickel cathodes. More nickel means more capacity, but it also runs hotter, so cooling systems must be top-notch. High conductivity solid electrolytes, likely sulfide-based, which are fast for ion movement, allowing high power transfer. Together, this setup is what allows the 400 watt-hours per kilogram energy density and the ultra-fast charging without the usual overheating issues. The charging game changer. Charging speed is often the deal-breaker for new EV buyers. Dongfeng is attacking this head-on. Most current EVs use a 400-volt system. Premium ones, like the Porsche Taycan, have moved to 800 volts for faster charging. Dongfeng is going over 1,000 volts. Why does voltage matter? Higher voltage equals lower current for the same power output. Lower current equals less heat loss, meaning you can pump in energy much faster without cooking the battery. Now add in Dongfeng's dual charging inlet design, and you can plug into two ultra-high power chargers at once. That's how they get to the 1,200 kilowatt claim. For context, Tesla's superchargers max at 350 kilowatts. At that rate, you could add enough energy for 450 kilometers in 5 minutes, which is faster than most people can fill a gas tank if you count payment and waiting in line. Why Huawei matters here? Dongfeng's partnership with Huawei isn't just for marketing. Huawei is already ranked second only to Tesla in autonomous driving performance in China. They're bringing three key things to this project. Harmony OS in-car system, a unified AI-powered operating system that controls everything from maps to climate control to entertainment. Level 4 autonomous driving. The car will drive itself in most conditions without human intervention. This is more advanced than the driver assist systems in most cars today. AI battery management. Smart algorithms to maximize charging speed without reducing battery life. The first co-developed premium SUV will launch in 2026, combining Dongfeng's battery tech with Huawei's smart driving systems. Dongfeng's EV roadmap is split into three series: mainstream tech series, affordable EVs targeting younger, tech-loving drivers, includes models like Nano 1, Nano 6, 007, and 008. Premium Smart Series, Huawei partnership vehicles for high-end buyers. Fengshen Series, compact and mid-size EVs with at least two new models per year until 2028. By 2027, they want to be in 30 global markets, offering both left-hand and right-hand drive. Starting prices could be as low as $23,900 in China for entry-level models, which is aggressive for solid-state tech. Why this matters for the industry? If this works, hybrid cars could lose their only edge: long range and quick refueling. Gasoline cars? They'd be like flip phones in the age of smartphones, outdated overnight. Charging infrastructure will need an upgrade. We're talking about a global network of megawatt-class chargers. But the payoff could be worth it. Long road trips without anxiety. Charging that's faster than refueling. Lower costs over time than any combustion car. Automakers have promised solid-state breakthroughs before. Toyota, NIO, QuantumScape, and all face delays. Scaling production is hard because solid electrolytes are tricky to manufacture consistently. Costs are still high for mass market pricing. Material supply chains need to adapt. Dongfeng's advantage? They operate in China's EV ecosystem, which dominates battery production globally, and they have government backing. Add Huawei's tech integration, and this isn't just a lab experiment. It's an industrial-scale project. Imagine the year 2035. You buy a car with a 1,200 kilometers range. You never think about charging unless you're leaving the city. You stop for a 10-minute charge, grab a coffee, and keep going. The car drives itself, avoiding traffic and finding the cheapest energy stops automatically. If this vision becomes real, the gas station becomes a museum exhibit. Dongfeng's announcement isn't just a new car launch, it's a challenge to the entire automotive industry. If they pull this off, the question won't be when EVs replace gasoline cars, but how fast. The next few years will decide whether this is the EV industry's moon landing, or just another promising prototype that never left the lab.